to copy him. They needn't bother. Right. The next item of business is a member's business debate, a motion 4086 in the name of Alexander Stewart on the I couldn't resist it, Mr. Stewart. You're too keen. You're getting your space. On the Safe Drive, Stay Alive project, this debate will be concluded without any question being put. Will those members who wish to speak in the debate press the request to speak buttons now? And now I call on Alexander Stewart to open the debate, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. Delighted to have this opportunity of securing this member's business debate this evening. And I'm also extremely grateful for the cross-party support my motion has received on Safe Drive, Stay Alive project. It gives us the opportunity in this chamber this evening to recognise the wonderful work that's taken place, but also to look at the challenges that are currently facing the projects as it goes forward. I'm delighted that some of those involved with the project have been able to join us in the gallery for the debate this evening. And I'd like to acknowledge the attendance of Melanie Mitchell, who's the local community champion for Tesco's in Alloa, and Alan Fords, who's the local area liaison officer for Scottish Fire and Rescue Service. In addition, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank, in particular, my Mid-Scotland and Fife colleagues, Mark Russell, Alex Rowley, Clackmannan and Dunblane's MSP, Keith Brown, and Ian Smith of the Alloa Advertiser, who have all been actively supportive and campaigning as we've gone forward have been involved in a petition for the cause itself. Like its counterparts throughout Scotland and the rest of the UK, the Safe Drive, Stay Alive project in the region aims to educate teenagers and young adults about the potential severity of the consequences of risky, reckless and dangerous driving. And that has attracted around 40,000 youngsters, Deputy Presiding Officer, over the last 11 years. I first attended one of these events back in Forfar when I was a member of Tayside's Joint Police Board. And I must admit, Deputy Presiding Officer, to after leaving the event, feeling really quite in shock. It was a very harrowing experience and it had a very punchy, hard-hitting answer to the whole process. The hard-hitting nature of the project is, I believe, what makes it so effective. Each event has contributions from many people affected by a car accident. For some, like the emergency services, the implications of dangerous driving are something that they have to too often have to deal with, and their life-saving work is sometimes what we should all commend and be grateful for. The participation of individuals who've been involved in an accident or lost someone close to them is very much part played in the way when they're dealing with the situation on stage. And a car accident can have a life-changing situation for someone, and it turns their world upside down. The inclusion of real people recounting real experiences of severe injury or loss really makes the young people who are attending these events think about the potential consequences of their reckless driving. The success of the Stay Drive, Stay Alive project since its introduction in Scotland in 2006 has been a real success. Back in 2006 to 2008, the average of 11 people who died between the ages of 16 and 25 in driving accidents. And in 2014-15, the figure had staggeringly dropped to zero, none, nil. This is an outstanding achievement and highlights the importance of ensuring that future young people ensure that the experience of driving is something they take away with them. Organising an event of this nature, Deputy Presiding Officer, costs money. We recognise that. And the regional campaign has a budget of about £23,000 to put on the event. And in the past, they had received funding from the three local authorities in the former Central Region Council areas. This funding is now in jeopardy, and there have been some discussions about how we progress it forward when councils are looking at budgets and reducing some of that input. It is also the first time that we've seen Safe Drive, Stay Alive projects brought into doubt. And I had some experience of that, Deputy Presiding Officer, back in Perth and Kinross, when we found that it was struggling to find funds and also a place for it to be performed and survive. And as a member of the Community Safety Committee and the Community Planning Partnership, I was instrumental in helping to find an alternative venue that was less expensive to ensure that we could involve and become part of that project. I recently found out from Stirling Council that they are very supportive of this project and will continue to provide funding, and that I really do welcome. They are putting their money where their mouth is. And at a budget meeting in Falkirk last week, councillors rubber-stamped the cost towards running a week-long safety awareness campaign. The council has always valued the event as a real, tangible show of young people and the dangers that they face across the community. But we do have issues, Deputy Presiding Officer, when it comes to Clackmannanshire Council, which has had a few of its own turbulent troubles in recent times. So we have to keep a watchful eye on what's happening across that council area, because we need to ensure that they can also complete and fit the jigsaw. I hope that today's debate helps to highlight the importance of these projects in the lives of our young people. It is absolutely essential that we do all work together across this chamber to ensure that the important project and the opportunities that the project gives to young people are continued across the region that I represent, but also across Scotland. We must do all we can, Deputy Presiding Officer, to maintain, to sustain and retain this invaluable lesson in road safety. In conclusion, I pay tribute to all who have attended, supported, participated and funded this life-saving project, and all the families who have suffered the loss of a loved one or whose loved one has suffered life-changing injuries. I offer my heartfelt condolences to them. Deputy Presiding Officer, working together, we can achieve much more, and I look forward to seeing this outstanding project continuing for years to come. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I call, it's the open debate, speeches of 4 minutes, please. David Torrance, be followed by Liam Kerr. Mr Torrance, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I would like to thank Alexander Stewart for securing this debate in chamber today, aimed at preserving this important and effective educational programme, Safe Drive, Stay Alive. I want to take a few minutes to tell you about the aforementioned programme, the Safe Drive, Stay Alive Road Safety Initiative, which is essential to Fife's efforts to reduce traffic-related fatalities and educate young people about road safety in my constituency of Kirkcaldy. The Safe Drive Stay Alive project is an annual community roadshow that delivers thought-provoking messages to thousands of young drivers by demonstrating in realistic terms the lethal consequences should they fail to understand and accept their responsibilities when getting behind the wheel. In my constituency, the show runs 1 week annually in late autumn at their Office Halls Theatre. Its impact, however, spans far beyond that of your average theatre performance. In the show, members of emergency services share stories of horrific traffic accidents and suggest how they might have been prevented. Victims of debilitating road-related injuries speak about how their lives changed in an instance after just a few moments of carelessness. Bereaved individuals share their loss and implore students to think about their actions behind the wheel. Young people are provided with a framework of safe driving, and experts share tips about how to be aware on the road. Road safety awareness can be a tricky subject to navigate in an educational setting. Safe Drive, Stay Alive does a tremendous job of balancing the tragic nature of road-related collisions with what can be done to prevent them. After seeing the physical and emotional damage that is done by road-related collisions, students depart the event feeling the harrowing effects of dangerous driving and are committed to preventing reckless driving. Central Safe Drive team marked its 10th year and 100th show in Stirling this month. Since its founding by Central Safe Drive, over 40,000 school pupils from across Forth Valley have seen the show. The results speak for themselves. This expertly crafted event has contributed to a decrease of 43% in Fife Road casualties since 2006. In 2006, there were 1,056 road-related injuries, and in 2012, there were 549. The same time period, there has been a 65% decrease in fatality. In 2006, there were 20. In 2012, there were 7. This downward trend in fatalities and accidents has continued across Fife up until 2015. Aside from a reduction in bereaved and grieving families, the reduction in road collision injuries and deaths has resulted in a lower demand for emergency services and money spent dealing with road traffic casualties. Safe Drive, Stay Alive has contributed to financial savings in the region of £45 million. For its Tangible impact and extraordinary production, the Safe Drive, Stay Alive project won the most effective road safety traffic management and enforcement project at the 2012 Scottish Transport Awards. Last year saw Safe Drive, Stay Alive Central win a prestigious emergency service special award from Central FM for its contribution in reducing the road casualty numbers within 16 and 25-year-olds. The show has been adopted by other community safety partnerships throughout Scotland and the United Kingdom. It's supported overwhelmingly by the Scottish Fire and Rescue Service. Extremely robust external evaluations of Safe Drive, Stay Alive were undertaken in 2011 and 2012 by NHS Fife, and these evaluations identified immediate change in attitude for attendees about safe driving. The 2011 evaluation, completed by 538 attendees, demonstrated a decrease in speeding and an increase in seatbelt use, with almost 85% reporting that they always wear a seatbelt. This amazing approach to road safety education and accessible and especially engineered programme, which provide effective in its aims to reduce traffic-related injury and death, will be eliminated without some kind of aid. A petition circulating Central Scotland now has many signatures, including many members of the Scottish Parliament from many different parties, calling on the programme's continuation. If the programme is not supported, thousands of pupils will lose the opportunity to learn vital road safety lessons and our roads will suffer. I acknowledge and praise the work of Safe Drive, Stay Alive has done in my constituency and beyond. It is imperative we maintain this project for its potential to make a difference in my constituency and across the wider Scotland. It is up to us to ensure that Safe Drive, Stay Alive gets the resources it needs to continue serving our constituencies. In conclusion, Presiding Officer,
I was just thinking that.
I would like to once again thank Alexander Stewart for securing this debate and also give thanks to all those who supported this motion and continue to support the amazing work of Safe Drive, Stay Alive.
It's not the way to do it because I'll stop you anyway, even if you don't look up. Liam Kerr, please, to be followed by Alec Rowley. Mr Kerr, please.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. And firstly, let me also start by congratulating my colleague Alexander Stewart on securing the members' debate. I'm particularly pleased to speak in this debate because just over 31 years ago, at around 9:30 in the evening, I was standing, shivering in the icy darkness at the side of the A702 near Bigger with, you don't need to know the details, but you can all see the scar running the full length of my forehead following a terrible head-on car accident. So any project which educates any driver, let alone teenagers and young adults, on complacency, recklessness, or dangerous activity behind the wheel, and of course the outcomes and impacts of that behaviour, must be supported in my view. In Scotland, we have a very noticeable and persistent problem of young drivers being involved in a high proportion of accidents on our roads. Road Safety Scotland statistics show, despite only accounting for 10% of licence holders, young drivers are involved in over 20% of accidents on our roads. Accidents which in 2015 included 162 deaths, 1,500 serious injuries, and over 10,000 casualties. Now, this chamber will by now expect me to talk about the North East. And I'm sad to say, in this debate more than ever, I must. Because according to last year's reported road casualties in Scotland 2015 report, the roads in the North East were the most dangerous in Scotland. The A956 in Aberdeen is ranked as Britain's fourth most hazardous road. Aberdeenshire and Moray had 429 reported injuries, accidents and casualties, of which 189 were deemed serious. Studies have shown there were more fatal accidents in Aberdeenshire in 2015 than anywhere else in Scotland. This is terrifying, because behind every statistic, these are real people, real families, real lives. And we are still faced with a monumental challenge to reduce casualties and encourage sensible road behaviour. The solution must be educating our younger generations to use our roads more safely. Projects like Safe Drive, Stay Alive are vital in achieving this. It is a collaboration between local authorities, the emergency services and businesses across Scotland, targeting younger generations to underline the consequences of reckless driving. The events deliver hard-hitting truths and first-hand accounts from the emergency services, survivors and relatives of those involved in road accidents, and communicate the traumatic and harrowing aftermath that road accidents cause to family, friends and Scottish society as a whole. And I must flag that members of our hard-pressed emergency services give presentations in their own time based on their personal experiences. So does it deliver a solution? Well, 40,000 attendees in 11 years suggest so. And as highlighted by the motion and Alexander Stewart, road deaths in the 16 to 25-year-old age group dropped from an average of 11 between 2006-08 to zero in 2014-15. Now, I responded to my own crash by passing the Institute of Advanced Motorists, now the IAM Road Smart Test, when I was 18, to ensure I was driving as safely and responsibly as possible. But that is not an option open or attractive to everyone. This project, and those like it, potentially is. So we must continue to support projects like this. Last year, the Minister for Transport launched his strategic road safety plan, in which he emphasised the Scottish Government's conviction that one life lost on Scotland's roads is one too many, and further expressed that the ultimate vision was a future where no one is killed on our roads. I agree. I was only this morning discussing with the Association of British Insurers their support for programmes which support young driver safety. But the project is under threat due to cuts to local government budgets. And as highlighted by the motion, the project experienced great difficulty raising funds for 2018. It would appear it requires a mere £23,000 to keep going. And I very much hope that Mackay's magic money tree that we heard so much about last week may bear one more gift this year. Thank you.
Alec Rowley, pleased to be followed by Mark Ruskell.
Presiding Officer, can I begin by also thanking Alexander Stewart for bringing forward this motion. I should say that both Mark Ruskell and myself have put forward similar motions. We did so because each of us supports the fantastic work and achievements of the Central Safe Drive Group, and specifically the Safe Drive Stay Alive Roadshow. I would like to place on record my appreciation for the time given by staff from the Police Scotland, the Scottish Ambulance Service, the Scottish Fire and Rescue Service, the NHS, and all the volunteers who contribute to the campaign and the event, which aims to inform and educate young people across Forth Valley, and in doing so, to reduce the number of road traffic accidents involving young people, and so to ensure that fewer young people are killed or left with life-changing injuries. I had the absolute privilege of attending a Safe Drive, Stay Alive event in February at the McRobert Arts Centre in Stirling. The event was planned and delivered with the intention of achieving maximum engagement from the young people in the audience. Although, as a councillor, I had been involved previously in getting the funding for Safe Drive, Stay Alive in Fife, I had never actually, presiding officer, attended such an event before. And it started with a DJ and a lot of music, a big fireman bouncing up and down on the stage, and lots of people dancing, and eventually including myself as part of the audience. And it was a real good feel, and I could see why that would have been so attractive.
Is there any footage of this?
To young people, I hope not. But I could see why that was so attractive. It was a great event, it was lively, it was really, really good. And then as I sat down, for the actual show to begin, a young girl sitting next to me passed me a box of handkerchiefs, and I took out a hanky and the box went along, and I thought, right, okay. But I have to say that I was then caught up in what was a very powerful delivery of a hard-hitting message. At times, the auditorium was in complete silence. You could not fail to be moved by the stories being told, or the real-life contributions from survivors Jennifer Howey and David Galloway, who experienced life-changing injuries as young people, or, tragically, of those family members who had lost loved ones and were there to tell the story. Each of them having to come to terms with the shocking and cruel reality that too often follows on from a few moments of carelessness, either behind the wheel or as a passenger in a car. And the evidence suggests that the approach taken by Central Safe Drive Group is having a real impact. As Alexander said, some 40,000 young people have attended the annual event in the last 11 years. In the years that the project has been running, road deaths in the 16 to 25 age group have dropped from an average of 11 between 2006 and 2008 to an astonishing zero count in 2014-15. This is a fantastic achievement, and it recognises all the hard work that has been put in by all these volunteers. There was a concern around funding, and I have, Presiding Officer, written to the three councils in the area. All I have to say have come back to me very positively, stating their commitment to future funding. So I think that's important. I've also written to the Cabinet Secretaries for Justice and Health and hope to hear back from them, because I think we need to have a coordination to ensure that this group of hard workers are not running about trying to get funding. I understand that eventually the last bit of funding was put in place by an organisation in England who put a grant in. So I would want once again to thank everybody that's involved. There seems to be a commitment there from the local authorities. If we can get a similar commitment, then I think we can work through the safety partnership. All of us can work together to highlight the issues, but ensure we secure future funding for what is an amazing show. And I congratulate everyone involved.
Thank you, Mr. Rowley. Call Mark Ruskell, followed by Gordon Lindhurst.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. Can I declare an interest as a councillor in Stirling, and can I thank Alexander Stewart for bringing forward this motion for debate here tonight? Important that at least one of the three motions was debated, and appreciate your efforts in securing this time. And I'd also like to thank the families who've contributed to this programme over the many years now that it's been running, and the volunteers as well, particularly from the emergency services who've contributed to the events. And I understand in recent years also contributed to the fundraising as well. I think that's been a hugely important effort. Now, I wasn't able to attend the event this year, but I was at what I think was the first event a decade ago, and I will certainly never forget how moving the testimonies were. The energy and buzz of the first part of the event captured the attention of the young people, though I don't think we had a raving Alex Rowley at that one. But when it came to exploring the real impact of road accidents, there were deeply thoughtful faces, and in some cases, yes, again, tears. And it reminded me of two experiences that I had during my time at school. Once at primary school, when a classmate of mine was killed out on his bike one evening, and the sense of sheer disbelief, really, and grief that we all felt the next day. And then at high school, when a group of local teenagers died in a tragic high-speed crash on the streets of Edinburgh. And it sent shockwaves at the time across the city that these teenagers, with so much to look forward to in their lives, had lost their lives so tragically and carelessly on our roads. Now, I know that over 40,000 young people from every school in Clackmannanshire, Falkirk and Stirling have attended the Central Safe Drive Stay Alive events over the last 10 years. And I was recently out in Alloa discussing the funding issue on the street and collecting signatures for the Alloa Advertiser petition, and was really pleased to meet people who still strongly remember Safe Drive from their school days and the contribution this made to their own awareness of road safety. And they've seen just a tiny glimpse of the pain and anguish that's caused by road accidents, but it's been enough to make them think not just about the tragic consequences, but also about how to take better care of their own lives and those around them through responsible driving. Now, it's awkward in a debate like this mentioning money because, you know, a life is invaluable, but the continuation of this groundbreaking approach does come down to the need for investment and a realization that alongside the incalculable tragedy of every fatal road accident, there is a wider societal cost estimated at around £1.2 million. Now, the Christie Commission urged us all to spend on preventative action. I can think of no better example of that approach than Safe Drive, Stay Alive. We're not talking about large amounts of money here, tens of thousands of pounds rather than hundreds of thousands. But so often, these small cuts to services delivered by external partners can pass through unscrutinized by councils. There's no single action we can take to make our streets safer. Members may be aware that I intend to consult on a members' bill to change the default restricted road speed limit from 30 to 20 miles an hour. Clackmannanshire Council has already largely delivered this, while sadly Falkirk and Stirling councils have not. But I think it's clear that through both education and regulation working together, we can make our streets safer and reduce the risk of accidents and collisions. And I think it's heartening, as Alexander Stewart has already outlined, that in 2014 to 15, there were no road deaths in Clackmannanshire, of young people aged between 16 and 25. We need to ensure that figure stays at zero. So, Deputy Presiding Officer, Safe Drive Stay Alive is an exemplar project that deserves to be built on and given longer-term funding security. I hope that all of the councils and other agencies will work together to deliver that funding going forward.
Thank you very much. Call Gordon Lyndhurst, we followed by Elaine Smith. Mr. Lyndhurst.
Deputy Presiding Officer, I would like to thank my colleague Alexander Stewart, not only for bringing this debate to the Chamber today, but also for the work he has been doing along with other colleagues to encourage local authority funding for the Safe Drive, Stay Alive project. Deputy Presiding Officer, the campaign employs emotive and hard-hitting techniques designed to make young people sit up and take notice of the dangers of reckless and dangerous driving. It ensures that young people can listen to those who have had to go through the ordeal of a serious road accident, whether that be the sacrifices of emergency workers such as the attending paramedic or the nurse that treated the victims of a crash, to the survivors of accidents or the surviving relatives of those who have lost their lives. Here in Edinburgh, a similar event, the Streets Ahead Edinburgh Young Drivers event, has been running for 6 years. It employs similar tactics, including various interactive tools, to get across messages to young drivers in innovative ways. And I am pleased to know or to understand that preparations for this year's event are now in full swing. Let me take a moment to pay tribute to all of the people involved in setting up these campaigns, as well as those I referred to earlier, who attend them to convey their experiences. It is to these people that we owe it to say thank you. But not just that, also to say enough is enough. We must strive for a day when road accidents no longer ruin the lives of so many people. The litmus test of a campaign designed to change behaviour or to mould the behaviour before a young driver takes to the wheel for the first time is, does it work? And in this regard, it does seem that shock and awe does work. The figures that have already been referred to and pointed to in the motion about the success of the Safe Drive, Stay Alive campaign since it was introduced in Scotland are quite remarkable, and I won't repeat them, because others have already referred to them. And yet, the greatest mistake would be to rest on our laurels, for the very nature of a road traffic accident is that a split-second diversion of attention can have far-reaching, disastrous consequences. Likewise, with the campaign, to take our eye off the campaign and to take our eye off the road would be a grave mistake. Deputy Presiding Officer, it is my understanding that funding had initially been cut for the Safe Drive, Stay Alive campaign within Forth Valley. Indeed, this may happen in some areas of the region, although, as I have mentioned earlier, the work of my colleague Alexander Stewart and others has helped to raise the need for continued funding. In my own Lothian region, for example, figures revealed in December show that West Lothian fares particularly badly in winter driving conditions. The Department for Transport figures tell us that West Lothian is ranked fourth highest of 206 areas for the number of injuries and deaths related to winter conditions. We all know how dangerous country roads can be if care is not taken. I am aware from a recent written question response that Transport Scotland is working to try to ensure the safety of trunk roads in West Lothian and also offering safe driving leaflets. However, that is the very least that can be expected to reduce the number of accidents. It takes more than leaflets to change behaviour, and safe driving campaigns play a vital role. Deputy Presiding Officer, until there are no accidents on our roads, there are still too many. I hope today's debate shows us what can be done through campaigns such as Safe Drive, Stay Alive. I thank everyone involved in this scheme and others around Scotland.
Thank you very much. I call Elaine Smith to follow by Claire Adamson, the last speaker in the open debate.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer, and like others, can I thank Alexander Stewart for bringing forward this motion for debate, whilst I note that others have lodged motions I think it's right, of course, that this extremely hard-hitting event, which has such an impact on young people, is highlighted in this way tonight in Parliament. I've actually not been to one of the events, but I was first made aware of Safe Drive, Stay Alive some time ago via a friend from Coatbridge who'd heard about the event from a work colleague. And as his daughter and her friend were new drivers, he took them to Stirling to an event. And as with many young drivers, on the way there, the girls had an air of confidence and they questioned the need to travel through to Stirling to be informed about stuff that they already knew. The journey home, of course, was quite a different matter. Not only were the girls completely stunned and subdued by the impact of the show, so too was their father, who himself felt that he benefited greatly from being reminded of the necessity of safe driving. As Alec Rowley said, the event that they went to started with a party atmosphere. The young people were encouraged to dance about to loud music and they were waving glow sticks in the air. But they were soon shocked into complete silence when it was made clear that the number of bright and shiny glow sticks related to the number of young people who'd suffered fatal or severe injuries caused by driving incidents in the local area. In particular, the compelling story given by a father about his son's life-changing injuries and the thought-provoking realistic video demonstrations were invaluable lessons to the many young people who were taking part. My friend was so impressed by this event that 2 years later, he took his younger daughter and her friend back to the Safe Drive Stay Alive in Stirling when they passed their driving tests. So I've got no doubt about the success of these events, and of course they also happen in Aberdeen, Fife and Tayside, as we've heard. And since starting the events in 2006, the organisers in Tayside firmly believe that Safe Drive Stay Alive has contributed to a 43% reduction in road accident casualties, and other areas also quote a reduction in incidents. And the projects have rightly earned a number of local and UK awards demonstrating their effectiveness. Accident statistics are, however, still worrying. In 2015, there were 2,007 reported accidents Scotland-wide involving drivers under the age of 25, and sadly, 36 of those were fatal, according to figures from Spice. And like Alexander Stewart, I would like to send condolences to the families who have lost their loved ones. Nowadays, getting into a car after you pass your test often appears to be some kind of rite of passage for many young people, and it's a practice which is on the increase. And whilst many might see this as something of a luxury, it's often a necessity, especially in more rural areas where young people can be let down by poor public transport and they need a car to travel to work or for leisure activities or study. And of course, as traffic increases, so do the risks. I certainly hope that the Safe Drive, Stay Alive projects not only continue in the areas that they currently operate in, but I would also like to see these projects actually extended to other areas of Scotland, and I look forward to the Minister's comments on this. I am aware too that this week a different driver safety scheme has been announced for Ayrshire, and I hope that that project is also successful. Can I close, Presiding Officer, by offering my support and thanks to the community safety groups, NHS, Police and Fire and Rescue Services, who not only take part and make the event so outstanding, but have to deal with such tragic incidents, sadly, too often. And, of course, thanks to Alexander Stewart for bringing forward the debate and to other members who've lodged motions on the subject. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Claire Adamson, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Can I also add my thanks to Mr. Stewart on securing this debate this evening on a very important issue. I also want to commend Mr. Stewart for highlighting how important partnership working is when we're tackling these areas, about how the Community Safety Partnership has come together with Scottish Fire and Rescue and other authorities that are looking to reduce accidents on the road. And in that note, I do welcome some of those partners to the chamber this evening. I attended a Safe Drive, Stay Alive event many years ago. I suspect it has moved on from the one that I saw in Aberdeenshire. It was one of my first exposures to this kind of project work, and I remember how the impact of it on me at the time, and how powerful the event was. And I think the evaluation that's taken place of the project to show how good it is certainly very valuable in how we decide to take these issues forward. As the convener of the cross-party group on accident prevention and safety awareness, I work very hard with organisations, including Scottish Fire and Rescue, with ROSPA and with BREAK. And we know so much about the statistics of the dangers for young people. And we also know some information about why those statistics are so bad. So we know that young drivers are 10 times more likely to be involved in an accident. We know that they are more at risk because a combination of youth and inexperience. Their experience means that they are less likely to spot a hazard, and that means that they're more at risk from an accident. And sometimes those experiences of recognising hazards can only come from driving and from that experience. The overconfidence has also been mentioned this evening. The poor assessment of hazards and the making them more likely to maybe overtake or take a bend too fast, these areas, and the prevalence of risk-taking. And I think this is one of the areas I find most fascinating in the whole accident prevention arena, is that we know that brains don't mature until people are well into their 20s. And the statistics show that risk-taking behaviour is because of the frontal lobe of the brain has not developed fully. So that means our young people are inherently more at risk, and it is incumbent on us to do everything we can to make them safer. So I would commend some of the other initiatives that are out there. Mark Ruskell mentioned the 20s Plenty campaigns, and I know that has greatly reduced accidents in my own area in North Lanarkshire. And also commend the government for taking leadership in this. Transport Scotland's vision is for a steady reduction in the numbers of those killed and those seriously injured, with the ultimate vision for a future where no one is killed on Scotland's roads and the injury rate is much reduced. And I think that's something we could all sign up to. So I was really glad that the Road Safety Framework review, mid-term review, was published in 2016 with a focus on particularly young drivers aged 17 to 25 year old. Can I also commend to the people in the chamber this evening some of the work that's been done by Dr. Sarah Jones of Cardiff University. Dr. Jones presented to the CPG in Accident Prevention and Safety Awareness on graduated licences, and I know that can sometimes be a bit of a controversial issue, but she highlighted that exuberance, risk-taking, peer pressure, sensation and thrill-seeking all contribute to young people being more in danger. The psychomotor skills, hazard perception, judgment and decision making of young people is known to put them more in danger. So I would commend her work to the chamber this evening and ask people to look into the real value of graduated licenses when it comes to this. And thank once again Safe Drive, Stay Alive for teaching our young people life skills.
Thank you very much. I now call on Hamza Youssef to close for the Government Minister. 7 minutes, please.
Presiding Officer, thanks of course to Alexander Stewart for bringing this motion forward, but also thanks to the other MSPs across the Chamber who put down similar motions. Can I congratulate them all for the cross-party nature in which they've approached these, and it goes to say that my experience certainly shows that the more cross-party a campaign, the more likely it is to succeed, and I wish them every luck in that success. Can I also welcome, as he did, Alan, Melanie, who are involved in the campaign in various ways, to the Chamber, and also congratulate the Aloe Advertiser. I've read a number of articles they've written in advance of this member's debate for their contribution to this important debate as well. Excellent contributions, Presiding Officer, from across the Chamber. From our own perspective as a government, can I maybe just reiterate a couple of points. One, that of course we're committed, as some members have mentioned, through the Road Safety Framework to 2020 to achieving safer road travel in Scotland. The framework sets out, of course, a very ambitious vision where there are no fatalities on Scotland's roads. Liam Kerr mentioned my own statement, another Transport Minister's statements previous to me, that one fatality too many. So it is an ambitious target, but I know that I want to live in a Scotland where this is realised. Underpinning the vision are very challenging casualty reduction targets. I was pleased to see that the 2015, that milestone point, that we remain on track to achieve these figures, these targets. Fatalities reducing by 42% from the 2004-2008 baseline, but with 168 people killed on our roads in 2015, of course, as Gordon Lyndhurst rightly said, there's certainly no room for complacency or resting our laurels, and I would give them that assurance that we're certainly not doing that. During 2015, my predecessor, Derek Mackay, instigated that mid-term review of the progress made under the framework and the approach to be taken. The mid-term review identified pre-driver outcome as a key priority, which aims to improve knowledge, positive attitudes, and of course, importantly, safer behaviours of individuals before they start driving. We know the vital role that prevention can play in safe drive, stay alive, is one of actually 12 pre-driver interventions currently being run in Scotland, which aim to contribute to this outcome. We heard from other members across the chamber about some of those other interventions as well. I think every single member almost who has been to the Safe Drive, Stay Alive show programme scheme will have, I think they mentioned the words hard-hitting, and I think that's very important, very powerful, because those hard-hitting, thought-provoking accounts of real-life collisions and their outcomes, and as Alex Rowley said, hearing those real-life presentations from those who sustained life-altering injuries, no doubt can have a very positive effect on attitudes, knowledge, skills, and of course reduce risk. I'd like to express my thanks, as I said, to all those who've been involved in Safe Drive, Stay Alive, again, the details of which we've heard from members across the chamber. And as I said, we are committed from our end to using interventions that will help us and supporting interventions that will help us to meet the aims of our safety framework. Now, all that being said, the image of Alex Rowley dancing has given me second thoughts about this campaign somewhat, but I say that only in jest, of course. And partnership working like this is at the heart of everything that we do as a government, and it's key to supporting the delivery of the framework target. I was really pleased to hear from Alex Rowley about the correspondence that he's had with local authorities suggesting or alluding to the fact that they're examining the funding commitments around this. I've got no doubt that all of the members who've put down motions have no doubt put pressure on the local authorities for that. Of course, we're all aware of those pressures on our government, of course, on local government as well. Liam Kerr making mention of the infamous, if I may say, Mackay's magic money tree. I would remind them, just to put it on record, that of course, due to the recent budget negotiations, there's an additional £160 million going to local authorities in Clackmannanshire. That equals £1.4 million. Falkirk, that equals £4.5 million. And in Stirling, that equals £2.8 million of unring-fenced money. So I just made that point, not flippantly at all, but just to put it on the record, understanding that local authorities have many budgetary pressures, no doubt, that they're wrestling with. We commissioned an evaluation of Safe Drive, Stay Alive in October 2015 to conduct a review to explore the extent to which the impact of this particular intervention and similar interventions in Scotland are contributing to the specific commitments within our framework. The review was qualitative in nature. The report concluded that based on the perceptions expressed in the study, there was a positive impact, therefore, in terms of attitudes that young people had in terms of those road safety messages. Therefore, in this sense, it's supporting the aims of the road safety framework. The report, however, further concluded that although these interventions ultimately aim to change driver behaviour, the small scale, perhaps, and limited nature of the study that was conducted means that we needed more evaluative evidence in order of looking at the long-term, explore the long-term behavioural changes that are needed in driving practices to help us to achieve that framework targets. So we're going through this process at the moment, Presiding Officer, of gathering further evidence about the effectiveness of pre-driver interventions, not just focused on this intervention, but as I say, the broad spectrum of interventions that we have. So we've commissioned, we've been working closely with the Transport Research Laboratory to undertake a project which seeks to understand get a better understanding of pre-driver interventions, and Safe Drive, Stay Alive will be a part of that. The report is due in spring, so of course I wouldn't like to pre-empt that, but of course members will be interested, no doubt, in that. And we're never complacent about road safety. I have a number of raft of measures which, due to the restrictions on time, I don't think I'll go through them at all, but all of them at all, but certainly members will be aware of what we've done in terms of lowering drink drive limits, 20-mile-per-hour guidance, and I've met with Mark Ruskell about the bill that he intends to bring forward, and fair to say that in the government I'm keeping an open mind on that, and we'll look at it with great interest, as well as high-profile publicity campaigns and, of course, ambitious engineering initiatives such as those in the A9 as well. Just to conclude, Presiding Officer, the Scottish Government has for many years been pressing the UK Government to introduce a graduated driver licence scheme that was mentioned by, I think, Liam Kerr in his meeting with Association of British Insurers. It was also mentioned by Claire Adamson as well, I think maybe one or two members as well. So the government has been pressing the UK government to introduce that, or indeed devolve the powers to us to do so. So it is disappointing that we haven't seen any movement on that, but I'll keep making the request, and it seems like that message has cross-party support to an extent. So together with local authorities and our road safety partners, we will continue to work closely to improve the safety on our roads, equip young people to be safe and responsible drivers for the future, and allow us to hopefully get to a place where there are no deaths, no fatalities on our roads. And again, I'd like to thank Alexander Stewart and all the other MSPs for what I thought was an excellent debate.
Thank you. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting of Parliament.